It was not a dream. It was a challenge I gave myself. With my damaged eardrums and with no expectations, I set myself up for a challenge, and that was to reach the Everest South Base Camp in northern Nepal. Namche Bazar and Gorakshep, both the places got me sick with the crazy altitude, but I survived to record this voiceover. A connection flight from Bangalore to Delhi and to Kathmandu. Delhi gave me an 8 hours of wait for a flight. I had to spend the time sitting in the airport. A smooth landing in Kathmandu. It was a hot day. Luckily, the package included an airport pickup as well. Kathmandu resembled many Indian towns, but I didn't see anyone honking unless required. The hotel room was in Tamil, and I did some last minute shopping with Arun Bhaiya, my roommate. And the next morning, we left to Kathmandu airport again. I read a lot about the flight from Kathmandu to Lukla before this trip. Only these twin otters and similar aircrafts can land in Lukla. And helicopters too, of course. The point is, it is scary. Lukla at 2860 meters is a small town in the Himalayan foothills. The trekking officially starts from here today. I had to wait for the other team members as we were divided into small groups from Kathmandu itself. I spent time here in the coffee shop wondering what steel Hillary and Tenzing were made of to be that crazy to cross all these terrains and reach the top of Everest. We had a good breakfast together. The first day's trekking was to Phagding. By altitude, Phagding lies lower than Lukla. It was the first day and we were all good to go and excited. And the places were so scenic with suspension bridges and the Dudhkoshi river flowing freely.
I'll give it when we reach there.
It was, of course, after winter, so it was dry everywhere and the sun was always shining. But as we were close to afternoon, the sky slowly started to turn dark and we reached Phagding by evening.
Hello.
It was an 8 kilometers long trek, comparatively easy. It was more like a practice for the coming days. At 2,610 meters, Phagding received us well with a cozy tea house and tasty food. These are small restaurant-type settings run by the locals in the mountains. And we all went to bed early as tomorrow is a big day. We set out early the next morning. A long day awaits. We have to reach all the way to Namche Bazar today. And that means today's trekking takes us all the way up to 3,440 meters. Snow-capped mountains are visible in the distance. It's crazy how these people survive here in this distant land without many connections with the outside world. In a way, I think it gives them the freedom to be away from all the selfish hassles that we have to go through. The change in altitude started hitting me well. Headache. Water was the only solution, and I was carrying enough for the entire day. Slow, steady, more water. That was the mantra. The push of breeze while crossing Hilari Bridge is something that you can only experience but explain.
Oh my god.
The headache made me sit, relax and think for a while. It helped. It took me a while to realize where exactly I was. I'm not in the comfort of my home anymore. And I'm not someone who can say that anywhere is home. So I had to teach myself, practice and execute what was needed. We reached Namche Bazaar by late evening. There is no trekking tomorrow, but we have to climb or hike a nearby hill and acclimatize. Because from the day after tomorrow, the altitude is going to be way higher. And to be honest, I was already proud of myself for reaching Namche Bazaar during my first trekking experience ever. Arun Bhaiya was a great roommate. Mutual understanding and adjustments always help. With a heavy head and little pride, we were done for the day. The next morning was a fresh start. Thankfully, the headaches were gone. We got to see and experience more of Namche Bazaar on the way to acclimatization climb. Namche Bazaar looks so tiny from up here, but it is a town which has got anything and everything. Schools, playgrounds, medical shops and all the basic amenities make this place the last dependable habitat en route to base camp. It took us almost 3 hours to reach the top, and through the binoculars, we saw Everest for the first time. We used the binoculars only because the clouds were blocking a clear view that day. On other days, we can see Everest, Lhotse and Amandablam clearly from up here. I stood there for a while, looking at the tip of the top of the world, thinking about the crazy things people would have gone through up there. How many of them would have regretted choosing to be there? How many would have cried out loud in ecstasy? We left the place after a while and went down to Namche Bazaar to our hotel room for a good day's rest. We started the next morning a little late from Namche Bazaar. Now that the tip of Mount Everest is also visible in the far distance, there was a new motivation and interest in everyone. Amandablam was also visible along the trail from that day. The remaining treks were through Thengboche, Dingboche to Lubuche and all the way to Gorakshep. The day we reach Gorakshep, we will be walking to the base camp as well. We took a long rest during the lunch break and soon our guide Lekpaji informed us that the weather was about to change. We did trek for one more hour after that and snowfall started. And that, to be honest, is the last time my GoPro worked during the EBC trek. I regretted not taking extra batteries and chargers. From then on, I had to use my phone to record, and my habit made me record in portrait mode instead of landscape. Dingboche is a proper Himalayan village at 4,410 meters, nestled right in the middle of most of the giants in the higher Himalayas. We can even see Makalu from here. I think this is the closest we will be to Amadablam during the Everest base camp trekking. A beautiful giant, Amadablam soars right beside Dingboche, looking down on all of us every day and night. From Lingboche, it was a long trail with twists and turns to Lobuche. After all the snowfall and cold in Dingboche, this long trail appears dry and shining. I got the vibes of Ladakh in many places around here. By then, it was clear that we'd be reaching EBZ in the next 2 days. One person from our group was airlifted because of altitude issues. We were worried, but she was okay once she reached lower altitude. With every few feet I crossed, I looked back at the majestic Amadablam and appreciated the beauty of that mountain. This is one peak I wanted to see more than Sagar Mata herself. By the time we crossed Lobuche, Amadablam was out of sight and Pumori had taken over. Pumori gave me the vibes of K2 from this angle, mostly because of the triangular shape. To say the least, I got sick once we reached Gorakshep. Crazy altitude got me. I couldn't even think of using my phone at that time, and base camp was already visible from a distance. I did puke a lot, but with the motivation of my group members, I did it. I crossed the challenges and reached Everest Base Camp by evening, but in portrait mode.